Hi everyone, this is Jan Wilczek from thewolfsound.com, and today we are going to talk about a very important topic, which is testing. Testing is the art of writing code that ensures us that some other code works. Why would you need that? Let me ask you another question. How do you know that your code actually works? That's the question that I asked myself when I started doing some serious programming. Should I read the code? How many times? Is 3 enough? Unfortunately, a lot of audio code is really difficult to test. This is why some just resign from doing it. But today we look at clean code from Robert C. Martin to list out the reasons why is it so important to write tests. In the previous video, we've talked about what I've learned from clean code when it comes to code design. In this one, I want to share with you my eye-opening experience with the book when it comes to tests, and invite you to set out with me on the path of testing. So let's dive into it. Why are tests so important? Testing ensures that your system works. It may seem straightforward, but let me ask you this. How many times did you launch code that you were quite certain is correct, only to experience that something went wrong? If something doesn't work, your tests are able to tell you where and what, sometimes with laser precision. Testing enables refactoring. According to the Boy Scout rule, regular refactoring is good practice. After all, we're in the agile iterative development process. With each change you introduce, you should ensure that the system still works as expected. Otherwise, after hours of hard and tedious work, you may end up with a clean, dysfunctional system. If there are no tests for the code you're refactoring, then repair someone's mistake and write them in the first place. Testing enables feature introduction. You want to implement new features. How do you know that they actually work? How do you know that you didn't break anything when implementing them? Remember, write tests first, then new code. Tests show the usage of your code to the users. If someone wants to use a class you've written, they may look at the documentation, but they're more likely to look for previous usages of that class. That is why the example section of each software library is so valuable. What if there aren't any usages? That means there are no tests as well. Having just a quick peek at tests can make you understand classes' purpose instantly, and that makes their usage much easier. Tests document your code. This is a little bit related to the previous one. Why write what your method takes in as parameters and returns if you can show it in a piece of actual code that is not just some comments ignored by the compiler? As Napoleon Hill put it, tell the world what you intend to do, but first show it. Tests show you where the bugs are. Most often, not every line of code is covered with tests. That is to be expected. However, the more tests you have, the more likely you are to catch errors present even outside of your classes. Test failures following certain patterns may show you not only where the bug is, but also the unexpected behaviors of the system. That, however, means that testing should be extensive, so keep this in mind when writing test code. Using test-driven development makes your system testable by producing better interfaces. If you need to interact with your code from the very beginning, you'll have a concrete proof of how the class you are writing will be used. Having it in code is everything. Having it in head is nothing. Otherwise, you'll end up in a situation where I've been with my poorly developed code. It's not testable, so let's not test it. This is not the way of a good programmer. Had I written the tests beforehand, the system would be testable from the very beginning. Writing tests is a sign that you care. As Linus Torvalds once said, "Talk is cheap, show me the code." I am not a person to judge some other programmer's code, since I make a ton of mistakes myself. But the single fact that someone has taken time to write tests is a sign that the person cares. And people who care change the world, or at least the system they're working on. That's about it. What do you think I missed? Are you convinced to testing, or would you rather employ a different methodology? If yes, which one? Tell me in the comments below. One final note. Many of my friends, colleagues, and fellow programmers observe that software testing is an area almost completely skipped on during computer science programs. The projects developed during various courses should only work, but whether the tests are there or not is completely irrelevant. Don't learn from that, and definitely don't follow that way of thinking. Always test. As usual, I encourage you to check out the related article over at thewolfsound.com. I'll link to it in the description below. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribing to the channel to let it grow. Thanks for watching and take care.